Better Minds with Rob Hardwell.
Well, it is one thing to learn about nature from a book or on a computer. It's another to get out in it.
Yeah, and for parents who are looking for a fun way to teach their kids during the time of COVID, look no further than a magic garden. Here's this week's Building Better Minds.
This plant right here is common milkweed. It's Asclepia syriaca.
Jennifer Ambs knows her plants, but she really knows her butterflies.
This plant, milkweed, is the only plant that the monarch butterfly larvae feed on.
This local artist spreads her wings by volunteering at Pocahontas State Park. She also incorporates some of what she sees into her artwork. No matter your age, she'd love to share what she's learned from her time in the horticulture industry and from entomology courses.
Well, if I was a parent and I was bringing my kid to this garden, I would first of all want to look for monarch caterpillars. And you can see that it's been chewing on the milkweed plant here and a couple other places.
Chief Ranger of Visitor Experience Rebecca Whalen says you can learn a lot from observation and learning from the other naturalists who volunteer here.
While you're looking at the monarchs, you might see a really cool wasp or another praying mantis, or you might see a bird. And those things can kind of empower you to learn more about the natural world around you.
The monarch is the gateway bug. Coming to a butterfly garden opens the gateway to learn and appreciate other animals or other insects more.
Kids can literally get in touch with nature.
This is Joe Pieweed. It's obviously a favorite of the swallowtail butterfly.
Butterflies are building better minds.
Isn't that cool? And Jennifer knows so much about butterflies.
Uh-huh.
So, and I like how she called it the gateway bug.
Yes.
The gateway drug. That's kind
of
fun.
And they're so beautiful, too.
By the way, you can find a link to Pocahontas State Park and to Jennifer's artwork by logging on to this story later this morning at WTVR.com.